The first thing I want to say is I thought it was electric out there. You got to take our hat off to the fans. Fans were unbelievable. They did their part tonight. I tell you what, and you give Portland credit. You give Chauncey Billups, his staff, and all his players a ton of credit because they came in here and they won the game. So I want to say that first of all. But for us tonight, I watched us do stuff in this game tonight that we haven't done all the preseason, all the training camp. The one thing we have done is fouled, and that was no different tonight. We gave up 33 free throws, and you give up 33 free throws, 11 offensive rebounds, and then you have 16 turnovers for 18 points. Right there, the possession game's out the window, and you're not giving yourself much of a chance to win. We shoot better than them from three. We shoot better than them from two. But we don't do the little things, and that hurt us. And then our defense was compromised quite a bit. So I'm excited to go watch the film, as crazy as it sounds, because I did not recognize the team that was out there most of the night. I thought the guys tried to compete, okay, but they didn't compete the right way, and we lost the game because of it.
Mike, is that encouraging in a way, knowing that you had this game right down to the wire, and like you said, it's a little bit unrecognizable?
From the standpoint that I know this group can play a lot better on both ends of the floor. Again, I'm not taking anything away from, Chauncey and his group, but I know this group can play a whole heck of a lot better on both ends of the floor, and we'll start by watching the film and getting after it in practice. So from that standpoint, I guess that might be the only thing I'm encouraged about is I do feel like we can play a lot better.
And when you look at a game like this, yeah. There could have been some things you like to fix in it. What would you look at, as far as the good spots of it? Because, Herter was doing really well. Terrence came in, and, he was doing really well. You lost the game, but there were some really good spots that was going on in this game. Where would you point out some of those spots?
Well, I thought we played right in spurts. And we always say, hey, we want to compete and play the right way for as close to 48 minutes as possible. And we probably played – out of a 48-minute game, we probably played about 15 minutes the right way, which isn't good. And a lot of guys got their number, but we gave up middle drives. We didn't crack back when they drove the basketball to keep guys off the backside. We gave up offensive rebounds. They scored 22 points in the paint just in the third quarter alone. We went one-on-one way too much tonight. I don't know. I haven't seen us go one-on-one the way we did tonight this many times, combine the whole four preseason games and practice. Usually the ball's humming, bodies are moving. It'd be interesting to go back, like I said, and watch the tape and see why, but we didn't do much right on the offensive end. And when we did, the game was real easy for us.
Coach Brown, in the second quarter, after a little bit of a slow start, you guys went on, I believe it was a 16-1 run to close it out and go up by four at the half.
Yeah.
What was the difference? What helped to flip that switch there? Something you said to them? What was it that went on?
No, it just quit fouling. I mean, we gave up 14 free throws, I think, in the first quarter. 14. Let me see if I do my math. 14 times 4 is 16, 21. That's 56. We were on track to give them 56 free throws for the game. We ain't winning no game giving up 56 free throws. And so in the second quarter, not only that, we also gave up 3 offensive rebounds for 6 points. So you right there, 19, 20 of their points were off of free throws and offensive rebounds. I don't know how many points were off of our turnovers, but we just basically cleaned that up in the second quarter. And we started playing the way that I feel like I've seen us play throughout training, not just the four preseason games, but even in practice during training camp. We played pretty good basketball. And that second quarter, then the third quarter came around, and you know, we gave it 22 points in the paint. We're turning the ball over. We're ISOing too much. And we're just not trusting that that ball is going to come back to us, you know.
Mike, if there was one thing throughout the preseason, you guys were the more physical team in almost every game. Did you see that tonight where, like, the physicality, like, cranked up, especially on their side, and maybe that's where some of your players started regressing back to what they typically do?
Yeah, 100%. You know, the lights are on. It's the game's more physical. It's fast-paced. Guys are playing extended minutes, and so they got to dig down deeper to play the right way on the floor. And we paid the price for it, you know. So, like, and that's why I said you got to give them credit. You got to give Portland credit because they came in and they found a way to get a win in an ugly ball game.
Mike, I know you talked already about really you could have played better was the biggest positive to pull away from it, but there are other really bright spots, the play of Kevin Herter, the connection of your starting backcourt, things of that nature. Is it hard to recognize and take those in after kind of a air taken out of the building loss like this, or are you able to build off of a lot of what you saw?
No, I think we can build off of this because, again, the way we played, I think, is correctable. And, you know, I want our guys to understand it's not just about making shots. You know, there's a lot more to the game than making shots. And Kevin, I mean, he shot the mess out the ball. Obviously, Foxy had a big game for us. He shot the ball very well. TD came off the bench and shot the ball very well, you know. So we're going to have the ability to make shots. You know, what I'm concerned, even if you go back to the Lakers preseason game, we didn't make shots. But what concerns me more than anything else tonight is I thought we held on to the ball too long. You know, we talk about playing .5 basketball. And everybody's trying to go make a play when it hits their hands. We turned the ball over. You know, we fouled. We didn't execute. So we lost the possession game. There are a lot of little things that go into a basketball game that none of us did well consistently. So the two things that helped us out are shooting and the energy from the fans gave us a chance tonight. But all the other stuff was too much for us to overcome.
Mike, a little bit of a quiet night from Domas. It looked like a lot of switching going on the other side. And I'm curious, when the ball's not running through Domas as much like you saw tonight, to you, is that more of on him or maybe the other guys got to do more to get him involved?
No, but I thought he had his touches. Now, he didn't score. I don't even know what he scored. He didn't score a lot. He took 10 shots. He didn't score a lot. But, you know, I think he had 5 assists. You know, so he got his touches. But I just I felt we could have moved the ball in general a little bit better, even when he got it. You know, there were times when he got it and there was a crowd there and he ended up turning it over or our spacing wasn't good. But for me to go back and watch the tape is going to be, you know, something that I'll be able to speak on a little bit better tomorrow, because I know the one time that he did get doubled, he found somebody on the weak side who found De'Aaron in the corner, and we hit a 3, you know. And so we just have to, all of us, including Domas, we just have to believe that that ball is going to come back to us, you know, at some point in time. And if we do, everybody's going to touch it, and everybody's going to feel like they're a part.